everybody has a fantasy, and my fantasy is to look like Salman Khan. So, but here I am today and not doing anything about it and still dreaming the same from the last 10 years. So what should I do to look like him? Obviously, I need to do exercise. I need to do exercise. So I buy a couple of sports gears and I join the gym. I set the alarm for the 10 a.m. in the morning, and when the 10 a.m. strikes, the alarm rings and I get up with all excitement to hit the snooze button. That 15 minutes sleep, it's so satisfying, isn't it? It is totally worth it, and not hitting the gym is totally worth it. I do this battle with alarm every day in the morning. After a couple of snooze, I hit the stop button and I go back to my dream world. So do you also do this battle in the morning? Any of you? Yeah, a lot of? Then we are all in the same shape, and that's probably going down. So let me give you another example based on my behavioral experience, that if you give me to do certain task or a certain project within the period of, let's say, 6 months, what I will do is that I will sit down, I will prepare for it, I will prepare the detailed plan, precisely writing each day what I'm going to do, equal efforts over the period of 6 months. But then I kind of get busy into other things which are less important and may not be required to do. The 3 months will pass by and I will not do anything. Then I will sit down again. I will prepare another master plan for the next 3 months, increasing the efforts for the last 3 months, and then I can finish my work within the timeline. But as always, I will not put in efforts and will not use my time productively. So when the things are going out of control, I will roll up my sleeves, I will slog like a dog, and will just finish my task just before the timeline. Have you also done this in your life? Then this is, so what is it called? It is called procrastination. What does it mean? In a simple terms, it means that we intentionally delay important things despite the knowledge that delay might be harmful. So what happens and why it happens? Let me try to explain you in a very simple way. We all have this rational thinker within us, but we also have this feel-good person within us. Rational thinker is a person who thinks logically, who will tell you what needs to be done, when it needs to be done, and what is important in a life. But the feel-good person is a short-sighted. It does not think about the future, it does not remember the past. It will just stay in the present moment, and it likes fun-loving and easy things. But all this is fine, right? This is not creating an issue, because when we are doing a day-to-day activities, both of them will generally agree and there will be no conflicts, right? But the issue begins when the rational thinker will tell you that it is the right time to do things. The things are getting out of control. But the feel-good mind will tell you, nope, let's have some fun. So what happens? If you can go back to the first example, when I get up in the morning at 6 o'clock, with me, this fun-loving person also wakes up. It gives me all sort of justification that you have only slept for 5 hours. You are going to have a tough day. It's okay if you sleep today and you can start your exercise from tomorrow. And my mind accepts those arguments and I keep delaying things which I should not. So there are certain situations in our life or things in our life where there are no timelines. So if you want to take a first step for an entrepreneurial activity, you want to start taking care of your health, or you want to start exercising, there are no timelines. In such situation, in such cases, there may not be a panic situation. The rational thinker will not overpower the feel-good mind. The feel-good mind will keep driving your life, and this will make you a spectator in your life. This will create a lot of dissatisfaction, discomfort in life. So what should we do? What are the ways in which we can reduce the procrastination? There is no right answer about it, but there are certain proven techniques which all of them may not help, but I'm confident that some of them will definitely help. So imagine that you have a bank account. In that bank account, you are going to get 86,400 rupees every day. You can use it the way you want, but the problem is if you don't use it, at the end of the day, the balance will be written off as a lost. There'll be no carry forward from a day to day. So we all will start using this bank account very wisely, whatever the money we have in this bank account. This bank account is nothing but a life account. Every day we get 86,400 seconds in our account. If we don't use them wisely, it is lost. We'll never be able to retrieve it. So we'll start using the time wisely as we use the money wisely. It is always the case of using the time, and it is never the case that we don't have enough time to do certain things and it doesn't follow in priorities. We sometimes wait for the right time to do certain things, but as it says, don't wait. The time will never be just right. The idea is to identify what is that 20% of the task which you are going to do, and that will help you to achieve the 80% of the results. You need to put those 20% tasks into your priority list and finish the task. The second method is divide the entire project into pieces. Because when we are working on the project as a whole, we are not working on the entire project. We are working on the specific task. The idea is to set the milestone. So when you are achieving that milestone, it gives you a sense of completion. And when you have that sense of completion, it keeps you going. So for example, if I want to reduce my weight from 90 kg to 70 kg in 3 months, I'm not 90 kg, I'm just making up. So it seems to be a huge task, right? 20 kg in 3 months. So what I did is that I divided this task into a small pieces. So I told myself that what I will do is I will reduce only 1.5 kg in a week. That looks like an achievable target, right? So I started doing that and kind of working for me. The next is you complete your most important and complicated task first thing in the morning, when you have all energy and enthusiasm. Gather everything what you need to complete that task and just finish that task before you get up. So I use this technique when I'm doing office work. When there is a complicated task, I clear my desk. I only have a papers which I'm going to need to complete that task, and I keep all the reference material available so that I don't get a chance to procrastinate or chance to say that, okay, I need to take a break to find something else. The third important thing is that you can stay focused and avoid the distraction. So whenever you're doing a particular task, you need to focus on that. Set the timeline that for a 25 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 hour, depending on what you want to do. But in that time, you will be only focusing on the one task. You will disconnect yourself from everything else. There will be no phone calls, there will be no WhatsApp, there will be no internet, nothing. For example, if I need to study for 6 hours because of the particular subject, if I tell myself that I will study for 6 hours, it is going to happen that after some time I will take unintentional break, and then that will keep on going and going and going, and in the end I will do a procrastination. So what I did is that I divided my studies. If I need to study for 6 hours, I told myself that, okay, I will focus only for 45 minutes and then I will take a break of 5 minutes. And I will do whatever I want to do in that 5 minutes. But that 45 minutes really helps and it keeps you going. Reward yourself. Whatever work we do with the motivation. We need some kind of motivation, right, to do certain kind of work. So if you're going to do some ugly task which you don't like it, then you tell yourself that you're going to reward yourself for completing that task. So whenever I have some work in my office which I need to complete and I don't like, I tell myself that after completing this task within the timeline, I am going to get a good break where I will have my hot chocolate or a nice coffee. Set the bar low, but you can decide according to your situation. And there are some kind of work where you can apply this. So for example, when I used to think that I want to do meditation in the morning, and if I decide that I want to do it for 30 minutes, as an optimistic, I started with 30 minutes. But then it turned out that I'm not getting that much of time in the morning. The 2 minutes it's not available. So I lowered the bar and I decided that I will only do it for 5 minutes. It eventually turned out that then I started finding time and I'm doing it more often than not. The second last is a artificial deadline. If I tell you that you have a 2 hours to complete one task, but you know that you can do that task within 30 minutes. The most probably we all will end up spending 2 hours utilizing that task. So the idea is to put some artificial deadline and complete that task within that artificial timeline. The trick is that don't push yourself too hard, because otherwise it will create a stress. So according to your personality, you can decide that you are okay to finish this work within 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 1 hour. And the last one, my favorite, is and very easy to implement. Just tell yourself, do it now, do it now, do it now. It gets into your subconscious mind and it becomes your habit. And stop telling yourself, I will do it later. Thank you.